Meet Ram. He is your average small town boy from India. All his life, Ram has seen his father store their money under his mattress to keep it safe. Sometimes that spot would be lumpy, sometimes it would be flat. Either way, his savings were irregular and never enough. Because of this, Ram's family stayed poor. They couldn't afford to send his sister to school. They could barely take care of his grandparents. And in emergencies, they had nothing to fall back on. Ram was prepared for this to be his future too. Until one day, a bank opened in his town. A representative persuaded him to open an account. All he needed was an ID. Just like that, his life became ever so slightly easier. Now, the government could channel cash subsidies directly to his account, which in turn helped with his day-to-day expenses. Because of these subsidies, he could think about sending his children to college. He had better access to health insurance during medical emergencies and loans during financial ones. With all this planning and assistance, Ram even started his own business and set up a pension plan for his father. As he grew old, he could receive money from his son in the city. Ram's life seems like the great Indian dream, but most of the country's poor still live like Ram's father day to day and hand to mouth. Because even though there is access to financial services in rural India, like credit, insurance and pensions, these barely result in genuine financial inclusion. How come? Most Indians are familiar with old school ways of finance, but not new ones. And so, they rely on a known devil than an unknown angel. But as savvier generations make up more of the world, it's only natural that they'll adapt to things faster. Kind of like how you're better at using smartphones than your parents are. India is currently plowing through the access to finance stage. So maybe the reason we haven't been happy about its progress is because it's too early to see its full impact. But once someone is genuinely financially included in the economy, it can change their life, the lives of his family, his village, and by extension, the whole country. The standard of living in rural India would improve. It would be great for the economy. And the national income will of course grow too. Maybe I'm being too optimistic about this. Maybe banking on banking isn't the smartest or most strategic way to uplift the poorest of the poor in India. I would love to get your perspective in the comments below. Let's argue this one out.